viewers, welcome to Limu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Phyllaris Tirit. Today I'm going to take you through English Form 4, Lesson 4. Our topic will be on listening and speaking. Subtopic, we're going to look at the mood, tone, and attitude. Welcome. Before that, can we look first at the lesson goals or the lesson objective? So by the end of the lesson, you as a learner should be able to define mood, tone, and attitude. Identify the mood in different poems. Describe the mood and recognize the importance of mood in poetry. So we'll begin with the definition of mood, and we can say the following. Mood refers to the feelings you get when you read a poem or the atmosphere that surrounds events in a poem, and that could influence how the reader or how the audience feels after reading or listening to the poem. You can also say it is the climate of feeling within a literary work. I also say it is the atmosphere in a certain poem, since it creates an emotional situation that surrounds the reader. So basically, when we talk of mood, it ends with the feeling that the reader or you or the writer gets when writing this poem. And so it influences your reading or listening, or you as a listener listening to a poem. The desired mood of a poem is created by the writer's selection of setting, objects, specific details, or certain words and the images. Mood is developed in a literary piece through setting, theme, tone, and diction. Now, can we look at tone? We can say it is the quality of voice that helps reveal the attitude of the speaker, attitude towards the subject. It's the quality of voice that helps reveal the attitude of the speaker, and the attitude is towards a subject. Tone is indicated by the choice of words and the stress employed on different words so as to bring out the attitude. The tone can be formal, informal, comic, sarcastic, or cheerful. Can we look at those examples portraying different tones? You can look at this in a conversation. Jacob, we're not going for the trip tomorrow. Mary, that's great. That's what I expected. The tone of Mary's response is sarcastic. Today's match will be better than yesterday. This tone is optimistic. Now can we look at the third one, which is attitude? And you can say, a perspective of the writer he adopts in a certain work, since it's the way in which a writer develops his character, describes his stories, and designs his or her works of literature. Attitude is important in that it bridges the gap between the reader and the writer. So in describing the mood, most of the time, we tend to use adjective because they reveal the general atmosphere saturating either a person, a place, or an event. Can we look at those examples of words that they can describe a mood? Solemn. When we talk of solemn, it means not happy or not smiling. Sorrowful, it's sad because something bad maybe has happened. When we talk of a serene mood, it is being calm or peaceful. When we talk of diffident, that means lacking self-confidence. When we talk of excited, it means a happy mood. Sad, not happy. Amusing, it's the one that makes you laugh. Nostalgic, looking happy at past, though nostalgia sometimes can be sad feeling of the past. Delightful is being pleasing. Remorseful is showing regret or repentance. Defiant is opposing openly. Melancholic is a sad mood. We also have other words such as gloomy, lively, pitiful, and angry. Can we look at an example of a poem with a sad mood, which is written by the poet, which is written by Amy. The topic is waiting for my dad. I sit alone in the darkness waiting, waiting for him to come back to me. Can he hear my cries? Can he feel my tears? Can he sense my breaking? Can he sense my breaking sense? God only knows such a fact. How can this be that he can't see me? How can this be that he can't see me? Is it because I'm sitting alone in the darkness? I just walk past everyone as if I were invisible. Can he see me now? Can he see the pain he has caused me? Or does he look past it? I think I should move on, but something tells me to wait. It's my heart. I'll give him one more chance. He needs to prove his love to me. As I return to live alone in the darkness, waiting. Wow. If you look at the poem, what is the mood? You can see that the mood is somber, the mood is nostalgic, the mood is melancholic, because we can see that the persona in the poem is waiting for his dad, and you can see it's like the dad died, but the persona still thinks the dad will still come. Or this is a man who went missing, and the persona still thinks persona is a child who is still waiting for her, for his dad to come back to her or him, and still sits in darkness waiting for him, thinking that maybe he will one day return, and so he's still hopeful that he can move on, but still his heart still feels that he should wait for his dad who will be coming. So we can say the mood is sad, the mood is melancholy, the mood is nostalgic or gloomy. Having said that, can you try the following assignment? State other two examples of words that can be used to describe mood of a poem. You can as well refer this to Excelling in English, Students Book 4, second edition, published by the Kenya Literature Bureau. Or you can as well reach to us on our SMS numbers posted, YouTube Elimu TV, Facebook Elimu TV, Twitter @ElimuTV_KE. Thank you for the lesson. Till another time.